the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. Good morning and welcome to this service. As we gather here to do honour to Samuel, who has died. Gathered here because his passing affects each of us in our own different ways, and we gathered here to give thanks for a long life, well lived, and for all that he has given, and all that indeed we continue to receive from his influence and legacy. We are here to thank God for his life, to look back with thanksgiving, and to look forward in hope, and to be ever mindful of the promises of God, that even in the face of death, we are not failed nor abandoned. And we find the words of that promise detailed in the words of our first hymn, which we join in singing together. The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want.
Pictures of different occasions throughout his life. Let us at this stage of the service ask God to bless our memories and to help us as we celebrate his life. Let us pray. O God, our comforter, you are our refuge and strength, a helper close at hand in times of trouble. Help us now to hear your word, that any fears may be dispelled, that any loneliness we have may be eased, and that our hope may be reawakened. For we meet in this solemn moment to worship you and to give thanks for the life of Samuel Kwame Appiah. Help us so to commend him to your faithful and loving care, and help us to pray for all who mourn, and assure us that in the presence of death, Jesus Christ offers us sure ground for hope and for confidence and even for joy, because he shared our human life and death, was raised again triumphant, and lives forevermore. Enable us this day to hear your message of death overcome and life renewed, that as we face the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity through Christ, our risen Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Our next hymn, Pleasant Are Thy Courts.
Thank you.
seated as we listen to our first passage from Scripture, Psalm 90.
It's yesterday when it is past, or like a watch in the night. You sweep them away, they are like a dream, like grass that is renewed in the mornings. In the morning it flourishes and is renewed, and in the evening it fades and withers. For we are consumed by your anger, by your wrath we are overwhelmed. We have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your countenance, for all our days pass away under your wrath. Our years come to an end like a sigh. The days of our life are 70 years, or perhaps 80 years. If we are strong, even then their span is only tall and troubled. They are soon gone and we fly away. Who consider the power of your anger? Your wrath is as great as the fear that is due to you. So touch us to count our days, that we may gain a wise heart. Turn, O Lord, how long? Have passion on your servant. Satisfy us in the morning with your steadfast love, so that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Make us glad for as many days as you have afflicted us, and for as many years as we have seen evil. Let your word be manifest to your servants, and your glorious power to their children. Let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us, and prosper for us the work of our hands. Oh, prosper the work of our hands. This is the word of God.
Thank you, Archie. We stand once again now for the hymn, Rock of Ages, Cleft for Me.
Oh, We're singing lots of hymns today, but as I'll come to explain, there's a very good reason for that as we give thanks for Samuel's life together. We're now going to hear our next scripture passage from Revelation. Christ makes all things new and brings and delivers God's salvation, in which, as we've heard, there is no more suffering or sin or separation, and all is made perfect in the realm of God. And so we can sing with confidence the hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine.
Yeah.
only fitting that after we have praised our Saviour Jesus Christ, we should turn now to listen to his words, which we hear from the Gospel of John.
The third reading is taken from John 14, 1-6, and carries on from verse 27. Don't let your heart be troubled. Trust in God and trust also in me. There is more than enough room in my Father's home. If there were not so, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? When everything is ready, I will come and get to you, so that you will always be with me where I am, and you know the way to where I am going. No, you don't, Lord, Thomas said. We have no idea where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus told him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. Verse 27. I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. Amen.
He lives, my mansion to prepare. He lives to lead me safely there. So those words of scripture leads us to sing our next hymn, one of Uncle's favourites. I know that my Redeemer lives.
Thank you.
we come to hear words about Samuel, and we begin to listen to his Bible. Thanks.
What joy the blessed assurance gives. He lives who once was dead. He lives my everlasting head. He lives to plead for me above. He lives my mansion to prepare. He lives to lead me safely there. Written by Mr. Samuel Medley, another Samuel, 1738 to 1799. The words of this great hymn were the last words of the man whose life and home call we are celebrating today. And he responded to his call in style at the Sycamore Ward Queen's Cross Hospital, as he summoned all his strength in his fragile body to blow his favorite harmonica. And I brought a copy here. I will blow it later. For the last time in the tune to this favorite in that we just sang of his, till there was no breath left, surrounding his spirit quietly to God, his maker, on that fateful Tuesday evening, the 10th of October, 2023. The late Mr. Samuel Kwame Appiah, also known as Kwame Osei Tutu Adiase, was born on the 4th of February 1935 to Mr. Kweku Bonsu Appiah and Madam Elizabeth Adua Micah, all of blessed memory. Samuel began his early education at the Catholic Jubilee School in Cape Coast, Gold Coast, now Ghana, and then at Prestia Catholic School, and finally finishing at the Methodist Mixed School, Salt Pond, where he obtained his middle school leaving certificate in 1953. Samuel continued with a correspondence course at the London School of Salesmanship, Cape Coast, where he successfully completed with a diploma in 1955. While training for his diploma, Samuel developed a great interest in contemporary music and joined a group in Kumasi called KJC and his Noble Kings, featuring as a singer and as a double drum conga player. Samuel, with the help of his father, opened a shop at Kumasi, trading in various household goods. And from a humble beginning in the music industry, Samuel soon joined the professionals as an event promoter and studio recording artist. When the Ghana Entertainment Association, under the auspices of the Ghana Arts Council, was formed, Samuel was appointed as the first secretary, a position he held for 8 years. In 1962, Samuel moved to Accra to start a new appointment as part of the security team of the then President of Ghana, Osagyefo, Dr. Kwame Nkrumah. Samuel underwent a six-month training in security administration and was appointed as Protection Officer Class 1, attached to Platoon Number 3 at the Flagstaff House, that is the seat of the government, Accra. Mr. Kwame Appiah served in the Presidential Guard for 4 years until the government was overthrown in a military coup d'etat in February 1966. During the insurgents, all security guards for the deposed head of state, including Samuel, were arrested and detained in one of the state's prisons called Nsawom for 9 months. He was later moved to another state prison called Osha Fort, where he stayed for 4 more months before he was finally released. After his release, Samuel moved back to Kumasi to continue where he left off, trading in chemicals and electrical goods. Unfortunately, lightning struck twice when the incumbent government was overthrown by the military led by an army officer called Flight Lieutenant J.J. Rawlings. The political climate became so dangerous, especially after his harrowing experience in the detention prisons. So he, together with other political detainees, somewhat sought political asylum in the United Kingdom. A few weeks after landing, Samuel gained employment at the Grosvenor Hotel, Park Lane, as a banqueting steward. He later joined the Institute of Molecular Science as a laboratory assistant, where he worked until his retirement. Mr. Samuel Kwame Appiah joined the Calvary Methodist Church at Macomb, Kumasi, after his return to Kumasi from detention. And that was where I met Oka. I was the choir master organist at the Amakumi Calvary Methodist Church. Uncle was baptized and confirmed as a full member. He also joined the men's fellowship of the church. When Uncle Appiah migrated to the United Kingdom, he joined the latest Methodist Church, East London, where he worshipped until he was called to glory. As a devout member, he organized some Ghanaian members of the Methodist Church in his circuit to form the Ghanaian Methodist Fellowship in the United Kingdom, a feat which brought together fellow Ghanaian Methodist worshippers in the Greater London District. When the group was officially inaugurated, Mr. Appiah was appointed as the treasurer of the association. Uncle performed his duties creditably, as most of you know, very meticulous, until he completed his terms of office. In the year 2005, Samuel organized some members of his circuit for a trip to Ghana, visiting some notable Methodist churches in the cities of Accra and Kumasi. The group ended their trip with a visit to the Ghana Methodist Conference office in Accra. And it was just a joy to be part of the Global Methodists. The group, a trip that has today become a memorable event in the history of the Leytonstone circuit. Mr. Samuel Kwame Appiah was also a member of the Ancient Order of Foresters, a noble lodge, and also a member of the Asona Ebusia of the United Kingdom. Uncle Samuel Kwame Appiah was survived by 13 children, 28 grandchildren, and 8 great-grandchildren. And to quote the words of our patriarch, Reverend Charles Wesley, "To serve the present age, my calling to fulfill, and oh, with all my powers engage to do my master's will." Rest well, Dwumfour Crew. Occupano Aquiri, whom Asun Jim, thank you.
No, you're not. No, you're a crow.
Thank you.
begin to hear words of tribute.
On the 10th of October 2023, a huge destructive hurricane swept the face of the earth. A mighty Iroko tree stood in the vortex of the storm. In resistance, it swayed, bent and sprang. But nature has its own way. Now we are left with a vacuum that cannot be filled. Who is going to fill this vacuum and replace our loving dad? That day became very shocking to us, as if we were dreaming. Are you really dead, dad? If you are dead, who is going to explain this to us? I remember 3 weeks ago before your demise, we visited you at home. We felt a very strong sorrowful feeling within us. We have now understood the true meaning of that uncomfortable feeling as a sign of you hope, as a sign of you giving us a farewell. You actually showed the signals of your departure to join your maker by telling us what to do and how to organize a befitting burial after your demise. Little did we know that it will become a reality as we all witness your lifeless body laid gentle before us. Special that like you is irreplaceable. Words alone cannot describe the affection you have for all your children, including others who cross your path and called you dad. You are such a wonderful, earnest, brilliant, generous, hardworking, a role model and an inspirational to all of us. You will not forget your humor and your wonderful smile. That none of us ever saw you angry in any way. Even the situation demands you to act as such. You were the backbone and an advocate who guided our path thus far. We say a very big thank you for all your immense sacrifices and devotion in our lives. You will always be in our hearts, thoughts, and our speeches as examples to our children. You have left behind a memory that cannot be erased from our minds. You'll be cherished in our hearts forever, and we will believe that the Almighty God keeps you in Abraham's bosom.
We now come to sing our next hymn. You will forgive me if I don't introduce it. And please forgive those of us who are ignorant.
Thank you.
How fitting. How fitting as we hear words about Samuel's life. Trust in the Lord, then things are done. We hear more words in truth.
Essence was woven into melodies, a band member where his spirit found ease. Strings of the harmonica kissed his lips in rhythms of love, life's sweetest scripts. Newspapers unfolded, the sun and the star in sight. Grandpa, a well-spoken sage in the world's changing light. In the streets of London where Hammer's anthems play, I'm forever blowing bubbles in claret and blue display. Family dispersed from across London, Ghana and the States, in grandchildren's hearts, love resonates. More than a grandparent, but a storyteller so dear, sharing laughter and wisdom, making distance disappear. Dressed with elegance, in a hat, long coat, and a walking stick in grip. Grandpa's presence, unique and strong, no one could ever eclipse. A grandpa, not just in name, but in intimate tales. Love crossed oceans in heartwarming gales. Communities cherished him and devised and a diverse embrace. In the hearts of many, his memory takes place. Maybrook and Leytonstone Church echoed with affection so close. My God is my Redeemer, his voice and a truth that never folds. His love for Grandma Sophia, a tale of shared love stage, a chapter of love, heartache and the wisdom of age. Tears of longing and love mourned but never apart. Their symphony continues in the rhythms of our hearts. In melodies of life, his spirit will dwell. In chords of love, Grandpa's stories will tell. With love always, your grandchildren.
So let us stand as we're able for our next hymn, which means
Jesus is the light of our path. He's a light unto our path.
Thank you.
There's a beautiful hymn written in the Sankey's Great Sorrows, a 19th century hymn. In the first words, the first verse of the hymn goes, "Fading away like the stars of the morning, which once shone brightly on their glorious days, so shall we pass from this earth and its toilings, only remembered by what we have done." A tribute to my special uncle. Ah, I miss him already. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith, and now what awaits me is the prize, the crown of righteousness, which the Lord will give me, and not only me, but also all who prove themselves faithful, all who finished their race triumphantly, and uncle did. And those words of hope and assurance encapsulate the life of Mr. Samuel Kwame Appiah, my uncle. Friends, the death of a family member who loved and served his maker faithfully is a bittersweet experience. Bitter because we lose for a time the close and warm experience of sharing life, the love, the deep affections we shared together. But then it is also sweet because beyond the sorrow of our loss, there is a knowledge and assurance that life is far better for them in the presence of their Heavenly Father. And that, my friends, is a great consolation and comforting. My uncle, as he preferred to be called, Samuel Kwame Appiah Esquire, lived a long and fulfilled life. So, my friends and fellow mourners, we've gathered here today to mourn a great loss. But more than mourning, we are also here to celebrate his life. An exemplary life of resilience, sometimes against all odds. During the latter years of his life, whenever I paid him a visit, Uncle would start the chatting with the first verse of the Methodist hymn number 427. Through all the changing scenes of life, in trouble or in joy, the praises of my God shall still my heart and tongue employ. And then as part of his entertainment ritual, Uncle will pull out his harmonica instrument. And play what he referred to as my introit, the words of his favorite hymn we just sang. I know that my Redeemer lives. Professor Maya Ade, let me see, Uncle Appiah. before his death, I called at Uncle's place to deliver a brand new harmonica instrument he made me order as a replacement for the one he dubbed the old soldier. Uncle was admitted at Whips Cross Hospital 2 weeks later. Little did I know that the race of his life was done. My friends, family, and fellow mourners, I have a catchphrase. The longest walk one ever takes is walking away from the grave of someone you love. And I'm sure most, if not all of us, will relate to that experience. To walk away back home into an empty space, knowing that things will never be the same again. To reach out and touch a face hanging on a wall, knowing it's over, gone forever. There is nothing we can do about it. That, my fellow mourners, is the longest walk and the saddest day in living memory. Every step takes you away from the graveyard of a broken dream. And that is the lot of friends and loved ones of my dear uncle, the family, children, grandchildren, and fellow mourners. Uncle Samuel Kwame Appiah, Esquire. But then we all take consolation from a memorial song composed by one of the greatest gospel musicians of the 20th century, Mr. Thomas Dacey, who a few weeks before he was called to glory wrote the words of this old-time gospel song that continues to give countless Christians hope and assurance of a better world up there as their lives on this earth draws a close. And that closes a beautiful epilogue of my dear uncle. It says, "Precious Lord, take my hand. Lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home." Fare thee well, Uncle. Yamin Fawin said, Jo, Captain Day, they shame you. Heavenly Father, in your gracious keeping, we leave your faithful servant, Samuel Kwame Appiah, sleeping.
We join together in singing the hymn, "How Great Thou Art."
I hear the rolling thunder. Sofo de Damasi. And then in Konida Mekasa. Na Kasam Kredi. Munsu day will brofum da. Obi wa wa su de obofuma opuna omu. Musu de wa mukrum kasin. Munsu de wa brofum. Inti in that su ye letting stone. And I'm the letting stone. But see fancy room papa or a day. Inti ye bobo sim m fancy as I'm a organist and I'm a behind. Inti me kada. It's important now. You know, I go by yourself. It's important to. It's important to. It's important to. How can I say it's important to? Because it's important to. It's important to. It's important to. It's important to. Let you know it's important to. As far as it's important to. I'm going to say important to. I want to say what it is. My son say what it is. Letting Stone Ghanaian Fellowship, or by two young. The Letting Stone Ghanaian Fellowship is going to give us a song. Thank you.
members of GMF should take part in our service when GMF has had such a huge presence and been led so well by Samuel for so many years. Welcome to this service, which is packed full of people. All of us united in one to give thanks to God for Samuel's life, to recognize his witness, his love, his gifts, his influence, and that legacy which will continue. It feels a little bit like a minister's convention. We have at least five reverends in this service today, and there are probably others. My apologies if you've been left out, but a particular welcome to Reverend Femi, who's at the back, Reverend Frimpong, Reverend Notchy, Reverend Norman. And as I said, my apologies to anyone who inadvertently I've left out, but that in itself, let alone the number of people who are here, is testament to Samuel. He has been a faithful servant and soldier for Christ in Ghana, here, and in so many different ways. The programme says that I should give a short address. And you and I know that actually words are not adequate to do justice to all that he has given and shown. And as someone who did not know Samuel, sadly, as the new minister at this church, I simply want to point out two things. We've heard the words, "Take my hand. Precious Lord, lead me home." And we've heard words of Jesus about, "I go to prepare a place for you and I will take you to myself." Jesus promises us a home with him. And Samuel knew that. He lived it, he proclaimed it, he witnessed it. And often we wonder what that kind of place is like. And Jesus says something, but not everything about it. But we do know it is a place, maybe not a celestial hotel, but a place where there is space and there is welcome for all. A place where we feel accepted and affirmed, where we are known thoroughly and loved for who we are, with our strengths, our weaknesses, our gifts, our reservations, where all is well, where we are safe and secure. And the man who worked once as a protection officer knew that his real safety lay in the Lord. Jesus spoke about that place in part to remind his followers that it was actually not so much a building, but about a people and a community. A place where actually everybody feels joined together. Everyone feels part of something. Everyone is able to contribute and participate. And I just wonder whether something of that life, something of that realm has been shown in Samuel's life here on earth too. In the way that he has enabled and encouraged people and brought joy to so many. And I like to think, if you find the image of the pearly gates a helpful one, that in the midst of that gathering which there it takes place in the realm where all is good and is made perfect in love, you might just detect that there are some new sounds taking place, not least the sounds, the faint strains of the harmonica adding to all the other sounds and joyful noises that are there. Not many professions get mentioned in scripture, but musicians get quite a big role. And maybe not just musicians, but those who also bring safety and protection to others. Because scripture, the prophets, the writers understood how vital music is for us to lift the soul, to speak to the heart. And Samuel knew that, but more than just knowing it, he witnessed it. He gave us those gifts of music which have lived in our souls and brought us so much joy, peace and happiness. We know he loved singing. We know he loved to inspire people with his voice. But he didn't just sing with his voice. He sang with his heart. He sang with love and friendship and faith. He played music not just for the ear, but for the soul too. And he wanted people to share in the happiness that he knew in God through Christ his Saviour. Whether it was making people happy through his work, his playing of music, his officiating at all kinds of traditional ceremonies, or even, as in his later years in Maybrook Court, acting as a DJ for parties there, or even dressing up as Santa. He has in so many ways brought a touch of that place which Jesus speaks of, that heavenly realm, into the things of earth, into the things of our lives too. And we take comfort from the knowledge that he is at peace and rest and inhabits that realm where, in the words of the old poet of John Donne, there is no darkness nor dazzling but one equal light, no noise nor silence but one equal music, and where all hearts are made firm in love. And Samuel knew about that love that bears all things, endures all things, hopes all things, and is victorious through Christ over separation and sin and all that is wrong and unjust in our world. And we give thanks to him for that love. We give thanks to God for all the love and gift that he placed in Samuel, which will continue to lead us on. Samuel has now come home to the one who made him through love and surrounded him with love throughout his life. He knew that God's steadfast love endures forever. He knew that nothing can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Saviour. And he witnessed conscientiously and faithful to the joyful love of God through Jesus, and in so doing has blessed our lives with music, with goodness, with light, and with love. We give thanks to God for Samuel. May God bless him. May he rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Faithful God, we thank you for the life of your servant Samuel. We thank you that you made him the way you did. We thank you for all the gifts and skills and instincts that you placed in him, and for all the way in which our lives have been touched by him. We thank you for the gifts of his music, his friendship, his love. We thank you for his gifts that were showed with the love for his family and his friends. We thank you for all the deep convictions he held, for his resilience in the face of adversity, his adaptability to new circumstances, and the way in which he simply brought us closer to you. We thank you for the memories of Samuel that we continue to possess and cherish, and for all his faithfulness. And we pray, Lord our God, for those who continue to mourn his passing. We pray for those who miss him most, and pray especially for his family, his children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren. We pray for the life of the Ghanaian Methodist Fellowship and this church fellowship, and all the causes, all the groups, all the concerns which are important to Samuel. Lord God, be a source of strength and comfort to those who mourn. Give them your patience. Grant them the gift of hope in difficult times. Lord our God, May we be given that sense, even now in the midst of our grief, of the light of your eternity, which may reassure us and help us walk into your future together. Gracious God, take our hands. One day lead us home to be with you and Samuel. We thank you that for him the trials and tribulations are over and death is past. One day we pray, bring us to share with him in all the love and the joy of your heavenly kingdom. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And we say the words of the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We now come to a time for viewing and our paying of our final acts of thanksgiving and respect to Sam.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the joy of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
songs of praises I will ever give to thee. Our closing hymn, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah.
Ladies and gents, if I could ask those standing at the back if they're just able to make their way outside just so it's clear for us to come through. And if I could also ask, just because there are so many of us, if we're able to make our way to our vehicles when we leave church so everyone is able to follow behind the horses as we go over to the cemetery. The address is in the order of service for the cemetery so we can make our way to our vehicles once we leave church. Thank you.
Bonjour. My was you bring no care, no. One hour wasn't there, I want to know who was fancy me. What's my country of my dad? When now I want to know my one fair and woman feet, a day my hands and we wait. I saw from over there, but I want to have what I want to know about that. My name announcement. Now, more than that, if you hear your crazy, your opera uncle. Now, one hour, one in a day, but son, and then one two. One crazy one, mon, what's the hall? Waha, where's the hall? What's an abiamo? I'm Mubatum, ebusuanu tu we siesie anonze ene binye ma ma hu ahu mo de kwetwe na anye na yebogo ezie ni efiesie iba na ya nsu ya abotu hu na ya nyimo ni nyina afei ye ija no pam kra kra asanti na afanta ma ni bi ole ye ye na ya nsu ya ye ya du nze na yi ne ze ye ba ye ni ji ono a awo wo mu dodo na osi bebi a yere ko ni sie ono address no obubu ni ono ma nka njiro oyey City of London Cemetery, Aldersbrook Road, London E12 5DQ. Nti enyo kra mona satna awo mon kaleman then we all just sat in a prison and said, Jesus, he did today. We sat in a bank together. And they all did this sat in a natural, but he said, Yeah, and so, yes, we will present.
That's about you.
Okay, two pound, my sister, you go.
Why?
On nobody will need you. Because
there are many black cars. You want to say a new one? What is your new one?
Storyblocks Audio. 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 Thank you. Storyblocks Audio. 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 Storyblocks Audio.
And just find out the way, ladies and gents. Okay, what you want to do is, sir, get the rest of the web and roll it up. See? There you go. We've got another funeral later, I'll see you there. And what it is, sir, we're going to lift, bend our knees, lift, and then lean back. We only got one burial today, not two. Okay, so lift, gents. That's it. Lean back. Then what you do is, sir, that web, throw it behind you. And then, sir, hold one hand, two hands, feed it through, like that. Alright, so two hands, and lower it down.
Add up on the motor. Samuel, Kwame, Appiah, Esquire. Bida yare to you mean, afe ube jia emunu mwada ako. Assassinate you. We sing the hymn and then the casket will be lowered whilst we sing Abide With Me, First Falls and Even Time.
Yeah.
abide with me.
In my fitness, O Lord, abide with me.
Umaya mompa. Utumfu yankupono wena muba kutu. Jesus Christ nuru. Nisye na nuru swaredo. I say, Fahen, uncle, Yene papa, Yene nana, Samuel, Kwame, Appiah, Esquire, Anna, Yen, Wafa, Yeri, Sia, Nini, Pedway, Ne crack, I want to tell for you now, Ne Trinunya, Nubio, Monya won't crawl for a wap on one uncle, Del, Enya, Snubia. And now we'll buy any rather Jesus Christ. Then you mean I'm who saw an ado. As I'm my hinny no more. On raw, on your woo, you soon son crumb crumb, not I say, Eddie Hin. Yanko Ponkor, say, and you dap him. Amen. Soon, Major. You war, and you did a pretty move on 1 hour. What's not, see war, no queridim. You 1 hour, where we are, some dreaming in our. Yada wase kwa wangwong ka penyina, wenye dadua osi pinyina, wa nche huma krom kroma, ote chire hene femu viaza, enyi intia no hongkumu. Wa adofu ne ufu kronkrona, wetwe hene mwe siyada adasifu mnunkumu. Na wame chichiri ahimano, eye ufie ete mahena akuma. Ma yanyi wana sese wenye anu huban, Eridi wano ho nkadofo ona mehene radi Jesus Christ do. Amen.
Amen.
So now we will release the soul of our father, our uncle, our grandpa, as the grandchildren come and release these dogs as we commit his mortal remains to dust of which he was made. The dust will be released so that whilst we cover and commit him to dust, the soul will be released in his heavenward journey. That will be done before the committal. Anamada otumfu nyankopon na wa friend yan nana yan ekun yan wofa yan papa Samuel Apia efi nkwe mu konara ne ncheninti yan so yazini nyipedua ah ofi da tim no yazirishe Dad inside. A fan coffin. And soon consume. In Huntuman, come Huntuman. Christ no di kaninyani ifi e wufum. Na ye nyimede, obenyani heni nyipedwia o wii efi o wum. Na wa asachere no ma wa ayede, mbre nara ne nyiminyam nyipedwia netse. Ajen kwa mubro hufo. Winse mini yadu wa kwa Samuel Appiah. Nikra yadi she. Jinida ogwana ofi wara wungwe mbu numu. Egwama ofi wara wungwe mkumu. Ozibo yenya edu wara wubo japnun. Jinitu wumbo bruhuna bo numu wa waa umji. Enye waa sumujua oma azi numu. Na faneka waa hote ofu wenye minye mkua. Owa suru numu. Amen.
Amen.
Meti nzibi fi suru. Ah, asim de. Ofi in de edere kwi. In shiranye wufu tide kwami apia wewe radim. Inyo, sun sumunese, wahumu fi wane brim. Na honi nyumedi wane chi. Amen.
Amen.
Wama ya mompa. Iradzi nyaji nkwa. Owa debi ijina wudofu Lazarus nende du sin. Na yana wile hu kawa kuma. Mwanu ba njanka. Na baba wane nchan biyono mbre mumehen. Yungu chila wu mkua. Biara wari za wile hu. Madana weja mbubura. Adi chila nikra weja za asha wansa. Nama wansi de, arisi wane de. Emi nyi uwinya nyi. Ano, irazi wa wana. Ma wamfa nsasa osipi, indani mra wunchan. Na wansina umu wano kwa jedim. Ama zde, wanya wenyi maire chichirina. Wazi wangu nina atuudu. Wazi obesi bialem. Kudude, adichin baba, sumefi o. We umabarka sininti. Tihien. Wayani Radi Jesus Christ Timu. Amen. Yaba ma yen uncle de ye bira yere to njum de ye dofu funafu. Wa kwen tu abadzi. Ahum de pane sarum brodo anya wodzi. De ye amen fo wunsie. If ye can kotani ye. De ye.
Yeah.
final prayer in the benediction. And if there are any if not, let us have the vote of thanks, and then those who also want to pour some dust on the casket will also do that.
And I don't know that for that the one you ask the waba now will be Jahen, Yan uncle, Yan papa, Yan Anna, Yan Mia, Yan Yanko, that the one I see P. Say, Nami Bois, Ne Adichi Hena, Ne Hude, a worn out bar, Nanker, no day, and I see Nasida, Mozimahen, the doing Nasi, Nami showing you. Amen.
What in shame this day are well good grammar.
Those who brought their flowers and all those things can bring it to the food.
Any breed, any Abel, son in law, for this year, Nedofu Kwame Appiah. You've been training with Yamija, Yamioba, Yamison, some crunkron. Amen. Woman, your mom, pa. O turn for young coupon, Monsieur Qua, what was sore? Now, as I seen you now, when Aja. You know, one hour, one and so. When you are out to one in some way, one each. Now, for what I was to Mujia, Otranta, say, you know, no dum one. I'm a bit of a watcher. Now, what the one in Russia would do? Ah, answer said the numin. We two, my dear, some panetti. Who etching quenu? On them, he ne radi, Jesus Christ, do. Amen.
Amen.
Omay engine shra. Afe asumujin and kupona. Ona mo nye ye ashem no bojano do. No di ngwanu wanu hefuke se yene radi Jesus Christ ifi eufumuba and kwemubiu no. Ama Kwame Samuel Appiah. On whom no booma sumujim. No ama humon so a ratcheter. In your war, Mumu's are also in you. Unknown in the Yaman canoe, Mary Sanson and Fin Sanson. Amen. Mummy and Fast, Mugin Co. Yamina, Sumugi, and your Mummy and Aunt Snap. Amen.
Best
father-in-law, thank you.
Yade hajento beye nya
hamya ye.
Yade anyeche odijau beye
she.
Yade hajento beye nya hamya ye.
Was team leader, first been a forcing family. One in shrink, our get you ready there, one of the in shrink, we jar a banner.
Amen.
I
Ladies and gents, if we're just able just to step back off of the matting, the grave diggers are just going to come in. If we're able to take the flowers as well, just take the flowers off of the grave. We're just going to bring some soil over for the backfill. Are there any family members who may wish to backfill first? If they wish, I'll come over to the corner there. Where are you going on here?
Just going around here.
Alright. Okay, so the soil is going to be placed where I'm standing. So those in front of me and to the left, we're just able to step over to the right for me.
You can't be there, mate. He's coming around here.
If you just let the gravediggers know. If we're able to move back for me, ladies and gents, mind your step, mind the headstones. Just step back for me, thank you.
Please, we are giving it to help those who are helping us. Any amount you have, please.
done, George. Let me.
Thank you. Sorry, wasn't sure.
Anything.
Yeah. It's quite difficult.
It's very deep. Yeah. They're covering the whole thing.
So once they're done, they will do the rest of it.
You're going to say some stuff.
Yeah. Thank you. So then we can lay it how we want.
Let me give you my phone.
Come afar.
Oh, okay. Then come here. Let me give you my phone. Let me just take it and show you.
Matt.
You want me to take a video of
this? A short video.
A video or
a video?
Short video?
Is there already on video? Is there already on
video? I don't know.
Maybe.
I think it is.
No, he's not in here.
Sorry, you're white.
Do you have
no upper body shirt?